moments in silence, take a deep breath, just close your eyes. Remember the Tommy, this is picture, always happy man, happy man. Remember walking to church with Janet. Say hello to everyone. Just want to remember this man as a son, brother, husband to Janet for 63 years, would have been 64, would be in June. Wonderful father. All the poor boys are like their daddy, always cracking jokes, you know. Amazing boys, spouses, beautiful grandchildren, his niece, his sister-in-law, and the family and friends. That's a relation to remember. Remember the parishioner, fellow senior. Let's count on your blessings. To be here, touch your life, my life. Say, God, thank you. And this morning we come before you, before this altar, and return this gift back to you. So with a grateful heart, we begin the celebration of our Mass. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. May the Father of mercy, the God of our consolation, be with us as we gather to pray for Thomas, William, Riley, and for one another. May Father of mercy, the God of our consolation, be with you all, with your spirit. In the waters of baptism, 89 years ago, Thomas, William Riley died with Christ and rose with Christ to new life. May he now share with Jesus eternal glory. The pall placed over the casket is a reminder of the baptismal garment of Thomas William Reilly, a sign of his Christian dignity. Baptism, Thomas, William, your wonderful husband for 64 years, receive the sign of the cross. May now share in Christ's victory over sin and death. My dear family, this morning we come together to renew our trust in Christ Jesus, who by dying at the cross has set us free and rising opened the gates of heaven for us. This morning we pray for beloved brother, Thomas William, that he may share in Christ's victory. And we pray for ourselves, and we pray for Janet and their children, their spouses, and grandchildren, family and friends, that the good God may grant you the gift of his loving consolation. And so we pray. Eternal God, you made the union of man and woman a sign of the bond between Christ and the Church. Grant peace and mercy to Thomas William, who was united in love with his wife, Janet. May the care and devotion of his life on an earth for the lasting reward in heaven. Look kindly on his wife, Janet, and their children, Thomas, Francis, George, and who else? James, all right, the favorite one, the spouses and grandchildren. I'm sorry, James. As now they turn to your compassion and love, strengthen their faith, lighten their loss, we ask this prayer to Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The family had chosen after thinking, so going through all the readings, so they have decided to have this reading. So this time I'd like to invite Thomas's granddaughter, Megan Riley, to proclaim our first reading from the book of Ecclesiastes.
an appointed time for everything, and a time for every affair under the heavens, a time to give birth, and a time to die, a time to plant, and a time to uproot the plant, a time to kill, and a time to heal, a time to tear down, and a time to build, a time to weep, and a time to laugh, a time to mourn, and a time to dance, a time to scatter stones, and a time to gather them, a time to embrace, and a time to be far from embraces, a time to seek, and a time to lose, a time to keep, and a time to cast away, a time to rend, and a time to sow, a time to be silent, and a time to speak, a time to love, and a time to hate, a time of war, and a time of peace. What profit have workers from their toil? I have seen the business that God has given the mortals to be busied about. God has made everything appropriate to its time, but has put timeless into their hearts so they cannot find out from the beginning to end the work which God has done. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thanks be to God. John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God. Have faith also in me. In my Father's home there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I am going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am, you may also be. Where I am going, you know the way." Thomas said to him, "Master, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Morning, everyone. Again, welcome to all of you here today. It is so good of so many of you coming together here at St. Pius X to celebrate Thomas William Reilly's life and support his beautiful family, who was his life. As all of you know, Tom made so many wonderful connections and friendship with so many from different walks of life. And he will be delighted to see all of you here today to remember him. On behalf of Janet, Tom's wonderful wife and his family, thank you so much for your loving presence here today. At the funeral home yesterday, the funeral home was marked yesterday. It was so overwhelming to the entire Reilly clan to see the love and care. Tom would burst in with gratitude. In the course of this human experience of ours, it is safe to say that death is such a mystery for all of us. Is it not? Whenever someone dies, it's always a sacred moment. But the world changes just a bit when a person crosses over from this world to the next. Hopefully this sacred moment can lead us today to a sense of wonder and awe at the mystery of a wild and holy lives, and to be thoughtful reflection on the mystery of death and dying. And most of all, to support each other in love and compassion. So, Janet, Tom's wife, and the children Thomas, Frank, George, and James.
Yeah.
And their spouses, Pamela, Lorraine, Chris, his grandchildren, Kate, and her husband, Matthew, Evan, Jake, Daniel, Matthew, Lucas, Megan, and Shannon. Did I forget anyone? No, that's good. Sister Audrey, niece Jenny, friends and friends, we want you to know that we are so sorry for the death of your beloved Tom, your husband, your father, father-in-law, papa, brother-in-law, uncle, friend, and of course, our beloved parishioner. We offer you what we can today, our heartfelt friendship, our love, our faith, and our presence. On behalf of the St. Pius X Parish family, where Tom was a member from 1961, pastoral staff, our music minister Karen and Julie, our acolytes, Loretta and Virginia, Father Chucks, you wanted to be by all means yesterday and today, but you could not. He's upset he couldn't do that. And even John, who did a fantastic job yesterday at the wake service. and he's here present with us, and of course he's a chaplain for our seniors. Sit by the Thames Senior Club, where Tom was so active. Several times he was a president. All the society, where Tom came, we chanted, cleaning the church, chanting the holy water, making everything is clean. Janet will go and check again. He's done a good job. She said, good job, Tommy. Our Columbians, Knights of Columbus, where Tom was always there. I had seen him several times for the meetings. Feast committee, Janet and Tom will come and help us. And Tom will start eating the food. Right? And in my own name, we offer our prayers and sympathy to all of you as you mourn the loss of our beloved loved one. We assure you our prayers today, tomorrow, and coming days. Tom and Janet always found this community of faith, their extended family, their spiritual home. Tom was a good man, had a good life, and a good death. We all are here because of our lives have been touched by Tom Reilly. The longer you knew him, the more you realize how remarkable of a man he was, how remarkable servant, how devoted to his family, how loyal to his friends, how faithful to God, how available he was to literally anyone who needed help. Always he will say, what can I do for you? May I help you? In these days, in our society, one of the highest compliments you can give a man is the simplest thing to say and powerful when it's said in earnest. He's a good man. He's a good man. Tom Reilly was a good man. Tom Reilly was a great man. The folks who know that better than me are Janet, the children Thomas, Frank, George, and James, and their spouses and grandchildren. And those are very close to his heart. The list is long of good things, great things, we could say about Tom since his passing on last Thursday. I jotted down just a few things that came to my mind. It didn't take a long time, long to make a long list. I won't send them all, but here are a few things about him we want to mark, highlight, articulate, and honor. For over 64 years, of courtship and marriage, Tom was nothing less than a servant husband, devoted to Janet's best in every way he could. She often says, he pampered me. And he did. Tom raised children who were as committed to him as he was to them. Thomas, Frank, George, James moved mountains to be with him as much as they could, to be with him these last few years during his illness. Therefore, Tom was a successful man. His 8 grandkids loved him and loved being with him and knew he loved them. His daughter-in-laws, they were like his daughters because he accepted them as his daughters. Because he never had a daughter, so he was very, very happy with them. He wanted so clearly what it means to love and care for your family and provide it for them. I learned so much about being a responsible man from Tom. I hope I can serve other heads as well, Tommy did. For as long as he knew him, Tom followed Jesus as best he knew how. And was absolutely devoted to his Catholic faith. Thank you, Janet. You also nourished his strong Catholic faith by your own Greek Orthodox faith. You needed that. Double Easter. It's also true that Tom was absolutely not perfect. He would be the first to tell you that. His own perfection bothered him deeply, too deeply actually, but still he modeled what it means to keep on trying to change and grow, even into old age with illness when it's hardest. Tom, a good man, led a very good life, and he was granted a good death. Just before he died, on that last Sunday afternoon, I'd given him the anointing of the sick in the presence of Tom's wife, Janet. And as we were talking to Janet, Janet said that the father will be moving him to the hospice. We do not know how much time he has. And I promised her, get the whole family. I like to get them and pray with Tom. Say a final goodwill, a farewell. And it didn't happen. But this morning I was able to be around with Tom's entire family. And we prayed. I know he died with a perfect grace and peace. Now Tom is in gentle arms of our Savior, where there is no more pain, suffering, coughing, dementia, and running to the bathroom. He's always wanted to go to the bathroom. I was in the hospital. I want to go to the bathroom. I said, no, stay here, you'll be fine. Now thinking about the readings, it's wonderful to see how this family is so neat and close. They never make their own decisions. Janet always get their children, except daughter-in-laws, they get sort of trouble. Right? But she killed all the boys and sitting down in the rectory preparing for the funeral mass. Francis wasn't here, he was in California, so we sent another three boys and planning the liturgy. And what George liked, I think Thomas liked this reading from the Sirach. It's a beautiful relationship with husband and wife. I think that's really nice. Janet looked at it. Nope. That's for my funeral. That's for my funeral. And then suddenly came the first reading in the book of Ecclesiastes. This beautiful maiden proclaimed so well. And that was the season. Tom knew all the season. Tom knew all the season. And then came the second reading, Aaron, proclaimed beautiful from the Romans. We need to believe in Jesus Christ, and we need to live for Christ. When you live for Christ, we live for one another. Looking at the readings, I think I just cannot talk about those readings connect to Tom. I have to connect with Janet, because they live together. That every one of God. So you cannot separate. When I'm talking about Tom today, I need to talk about Janet. It's impossible. Impossible. When I came first in this parish in 2013, and first thing I had a visitor, Tom and Janet, inviting me for their senior club's core group meeting at a nice restaurant at restaurant over here, the Plainview residence now. I forgot the name of the restaurant. So they invited me over there, invited to their whole group. And I felt so home. I felt so home. And ever since, I've been walking with them. And I was so happy that when Thompson came, I was there with Janet. And that brought comfort to me personally. At least I could pray with him. I could anoint him. Tom and Janet have so much given to this parish. I'm not talking the financial part of you, but the time, the talent be there. Can you believe the 45 years they did the pre-Cana? 45 years. I don't think anybody has done it in this diocese. And the right thing they deserved, the St. Agnes Medal Award. It was given to them. I was happy to see their name because their dedication, love. When I put their picture on the parish website, the one of the guys said, oh, this is a couple. I put them together. I couldn't separate Tom and nobody recognized. So Janet and one guy said, well, we did the pre-Cana. How much we enjoyed in their house. I came to their house, participated, talking every night, they're talking about their own experiences. Helping this couple to start their Christian journey as a husband and wife. Sometimes we cannot do. I prefer the couples do because they do the better job. Because you have experience. There are ups and downs in the life, and you work together. And I want to thank Janet for this, for your dedicated commitment. No matter whenever you were there to do it, you came and you did. When you said, Thomas, I do, and the priest has told you, well, when you have children, you will raise them as a Catholic. And she did. You all instilled this beautiful Christian gospel values in children's lives, and I can see that. So beautiful. Tom had a great sense of humor, and then George catches that. I like him a lot. He's my another pal. And Thomas always had a cracking jokes, always there. You say something, boom, you'll get it back with a great sense of humor. So I'm going to miss about that time. And today's gospel, Deacon John proclaimed St. Thomas asked a question. How do I know where you're going? Thomas was doubting Thomas. He didn't know where to go. He just said, I'm the way, the truth, and the life, to believe. He never believed. After his resurrection, he says, I cannot believe that Jesus reason. His friends are telling, disciples are telling, no. They said, no, I won't believe. Unless until put my hands in his wounds, I will not believe. And the next day, Thomas was there with his disciples. Jesus appeared to them. Appeared to them. First thing he said, peace be with you, Thomas, come here. Look at my hands, look at my side. Put your finger here. And he was amazed. They did it, what Jesus told. What he said, the simple words he used, my Lord, my God. Yes, Thomas' journey was pretty confusing. Sometimes you didn't know what to do, where to do, what to do. Janet, what Jesus Christ for him. He gave direction to him. Always calm him down. Always help him. Always told him, it's okay. Finally, led him to Jesus. There is a lot to share, a lot to talk. I'm just overwhelmed with the thoughts. This morning, like I was just got up at 4 o'clock and I was just preparing my liturgy, preparing my things. And there's so many thoughts came to mind. What a man, remarkable man. Love the family, love the country, love the people. Tremendous loss for us. We are sad. At the same time, I'm happy for him. I think God took him quickly. Needed. I think this little will not prolong the life, to make the life decision. I think God was great for him. I said, we relieve you, Lord, and relieved you all. Within 6 hours in the hospice, he was calm peacefully. So Tom is a far better place. I'm happy for him. He'd be Jesus. He's with his parents. He's with his in-laws. And so many people are gone before him. Lately, so many seniors we have lost. Wonderful people. I'm sure we must have joined their club. Was we cracking jokes, having some fun, telling the stories. And he did what he did. And so we say, eternal rest. Grant unto him, O Lord, let the perpetual light shine upon him. May beloved brother Thomas rest in peace. Amen. May soul and souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. I'd like to invite Kate Reilly Mackey, along with us and Matt, to lead us into the breath of faithful. For those who live a sincere and good life, the hour of death is transformed into hour of glory because Christ gives them the crown of eternal life. Let us pray in our hour of loss.
Okay, our response, risen Lord, hear our prayer.
Please repeat, risen Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord Jesus, you washed our Papa Thomas William Reilly with the waters of baptism. You anointed him with the oil of the Holy Spirit and nourished him at your table. Give him now a place among your saints and chosen ones. We pray to the Lord.
Please, the Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for our Papa. May God receive him kindly with generosity and forgiveness and the rewards of his faith. May he continue to inspire us, to intercede for us, and be there at the end to welcome us in our turn into eternal life. We pray to the Lord.
Please, Lord, hear our prayers.
We give thanks for all the life enriching and loving qualities that made Papa such a wonderful gift to all who knew and loved him. Sharpen our awareness of how we can reach out to others like he did. We pray to the Lord.
Please, Lord, hear our prayers.
We thank God for the gift and privilege of knowing our Papa, and thank God for the joy and laughter and smiles he brought into our lives. We praise the Lord. For our country and those who defend it, may our men and women who serve in the military be kept safe from all harm. We praise the Lord. For all deceased relatives and friends of the Reilly and Sebastakis families, remembering Papa's parents, Frank and Mary Reilly, his in-laws Martha and George, his brother-in-law Frank Sebastakis, may they all share an everlasting home with our Savior Jesus Christ. We praise the Lord. For the family and friends of Papa, especially, we pray for his beloved wife and our Nana Janet, his children Thomas, Frank, George, James, and their spouses Pamela, Lorraine, Chris, his grandchildren, me, Kate, and my husband, Matthew, Aaron, Jake, Daniel, Matthew, Lucas, Megan, and Shannon, sister-in-law, Audrey, niece, Jenny, relative and friends, may they be strengthened by the love they share. We praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Father, into your hands, we commend the soul of our brother, Thomas William Reilly. Look gently upon Thomas. Bring Tommy home to your kingdom, where death will be no more. We ask this prayer to Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And together, we turn to Mary, our beloved mother, in our time of pain and sorrow. Hail Mary,
full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women.
Blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy
Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners. Invite Thomas's granddaughters, Kate, Erin, Megan, Shannon Riley, and also his niece, Jenny.
Thank you.
beautiful parish family. Pray that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. As we humbly present to you this sacrificial offering of bread and wine, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Thomas William, we ask your mercy that Tom, who did not doubt your son Jesus to be loving Savior, may find in Christ merciful judge, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For Jesus is the salvation of the world, the life of the human race, and the resurrection of the dead. Through Jesus, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we all acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts of bread and wine, we pray, by setting down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, Jesus took bread, giving thanks and praise. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciple, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, Jesus took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ's death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the cup of eternal salvation, and giving thanks that you are this worthy to be in your presence and minister to you, humbly we pray that partaking of the body and bread of Jesus Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our beloved Pope,
John, our bishop, all the other bishops, priests, religious, deacons, and all those who minister to holy people. Remember, Father, our families and our friends, and remember Tom's family, his wife, children, his daughter-in-laws, his grandchildren, and the family members, all his friends, and our city of Club. Lord, comfort them, console them, and be with them. We pray for men and women of Litchfield, all our veterans. Remember also this morning, Thomas, William Reilly, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Granted, Tom was united with your son Jesus in a death like his. May also be one with him in his resurrection. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the Mother of the Church, our Lady of Consolation, Saint Joseph, her most cherished spouse, Saint Pius X, our patron, Saint Agnes, Padre Pio, Saint Teresa of Calcutta, Saint Francis, Saint Thomas, Saint William the Abbot, and all the friends of Jesus the Lord will sing the song of joy.
Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honors is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Said the prayers, said the prayers, quite loud out, so we know Tom was here. And last time I saw him in the hospital giving the anointing, I said the prayer, and Tom responded to those prayers in spite of pain, in spite of dementia. He said the prayer, Our Father, help Mary. And this morning is the last time we celebrate this beautiful gift of life in this Mass of Resurrection. Let us say that prayer, which Tom loved, we all love, because it has come from our loving Savior Jesus. And so we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our day, that by the help of your mercy, we may always free from sin and safe from all distress, as you have been the blessed hope at the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and glory, Lord Jesus Christ, said to your apostle, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant us peace and unity of your kingdom. But live forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of a loving and compassionate Jesus be with you all.
And
I ask you at this time, let us pause. Let us pause for a peace. We all need a peace. The trials and tribulation, pain and sorrow, aches and pains. May the peace of the Lord be with you. With your friends and families too. Let it be, let it grow, and everywhere you go, may the peace of the Lord follow you.
Let us offer another sign of peace.
Thank you.
My dear family, behold, this is Jesus, the Son of God and Son of Mary, our brother, one who offers us eternal life. As reminded Thomas, that he is the way, the truth, and the life. And blessed indeed we are to be invited to the table of his love. And prayerfully we all can sit together. Lord, I am not worthy. As in the Bible, but in the word, so shall we. May the body and blood of Jesus Christ bring us to everlasting life. Amen. All those are prepared to receive the Eucharist, please come forward. Invite Thomas, our children, except James, everybody. Give us some remembrance.
thank you to everyone for coming this morning. And Father Valentine, you'll be happy to know that you have been selected as the fifth Reilly brother. All right, obviously you know that very well. So welcome to the Plainview.
All right, thank you.
You got my name on the wheel, okay? You know how she likes to shop.
Yes.
I am Thomas William Reilly, Jr., second of his name, firstborn of Janet, servant to Pamela, Kate, and Erin, and protector of the realm. People will forget what you said. People will forget what you did. But people will never forget how you made them feel. Maya Angelou said it, and Tom Reilly lived it. What makes you think of it when he does? This has been a rough week for our family. At the end of a very long battle with Alzheimer's. This terrible disease tries to strip its victim of their dignity and distance them from their loved ones. That didn't happen here because we wouldn't allow it. My mom did the hard work every day, keeping Dad active and involved with his friends and family. You all welcomed him to your group, even when it wasn't easy to do it. But as he has always done, he made it impossible to not love it. Right. His amazing sense of humor and beautiful, happiest guy in the world smile that all of you mentioned this week continue to shine through. He was and always will be the life of the party. One of Dad's favorite movies was the Christmas classic, It's a Wonderful Life. If you remember at the end, George Bailey opens a gift from his guardian angel, Clarence. And it's a copy of Mark Twain's new book, The Adventures of Tom Sawyer. On the very first page is a note from Clarence that says, "Remember, no man is a failure who has friends. Thanks for the wings." Clearly, Dad had a wonderful life. Way to go, Dad. Thank you.
Hello, everyone. Thank you for coming. I'm number two.
Tries harder.
Tom Reilly is unfailingly friendly. He is the kind of man who says hello to everyone, even to strangers in elevators. People, being people, are very wary of men they do not know who are friendly to them in elevators. So it is always fun getting into elevators with Tom Reilly. Tom Reilly works hard. He works late nights and drives his family long distances regularly for weekend getaways. While his boys laugh and play and beat each other's upper arms black and blue just above the sleeve line, Tom Reilly is hammering in shingles or fixing plumbing or other things that Janet Reilly has helpfully recommended. Tom Reilly recognizes the beauty inherent
and an elegantly constructed bad joke. To Tom Reilly, a groan in response to a joke is worth its weight in gold. Ask me if I know how to spell banana, he says to me. Do you know how to spell banana, I ask him. I know how to spell banana, he says. I just don't know when to stop. Tom Reilly's lived example of fatherhood is a beam of light shot into the prism of his family. His sons issue the refracted rays of that light into the families of their own, each ray of a singular color and each of an equal strength. There is love in that light, and nurturance and forbearance and humor and steadfastness and above all, heart. Tom Reilly loves Janet Reilly. They laugh and dance and fight and sing together. Tom and Janet Reilly do everything together from the very beginning to the very end. Tom and Janet Reilly set a very high bar. I dare you, world, to meet their measure. If you can, there's hope for us all. Thank you.
That is why you go before the writer.
Good morning, everybody. Two tough acts to follow. I was going to write down some things, but you know, I realized that we lived it. So, Father, first of all, I want to thank you for making me feel very comfortable. Even when we were right up there, I knew you had something up your sleeve with the holy water. You told me to stand up tall, so I did, and then bang, right in the eye. So, I'm a little, like, you know, still trying to hear it a little bit. So thank you for that. But, you talk about Pop, you talk about the patience that he had. And, I wasn't the best kid in school. You know, I had problems in math, and I had patience. And then I realized that I had problems in social studies, problems in English, problems in everything. But he had the patience to teach me, you know, what I needed to learn. And that's one thing that I've taken from him into all my jobs, to have patience, treat people with respect, treat them well, and he taught that to me very well. My dad taught me the Our Father. And when we say it, he used to look at me all the time. So, not having him here to be able to do that was tough, but that's one thing that I'll take away and remember forever. So, we love you. We love you, Pop. I know I can say for myself and for Tommy and for Frankie, and what's that other guy's name? Jimmy.
Jim.
We all love you very much. We already miss you. And I just also want to say, Mom, what you do was incredible. And it wasn't easy. But you always put yourself second when it came to that. And I just want you to know that it has not gone unnoticed. And we love you.
Thank you, good night. I'm James Reilly that no one remembers. The youngest son, the last one, spoke yesterday, so I'm gonna make it kind of quick. I need my glasses. My dad would say, where's my glasses?
Oh, my glasses. Father, thank you for having us. Thank you for your help. It's been a lot of fun, actually. It's a celebration. As I said yesterday, a few years ago, 21 years ago, I lost a good friend in 9/11. And this was read at his memorial service. It's fitting for a Navy man, someone who's been in the military. I think he'd be honored by this, and you've probably heard it. It's called the Dash. Try to get through this quick. I read of a man who stood and spoke at a funeral for a friend. He referred to the dates of the tombstone from the beginning to the end. He noted first the date of birth and spoke the following date with tears. But he said what mattered most was the dash between the years. For that dash represents all of the time that they'll spend life on earth. Only those who love them know what that little line is worth. For it matters not much of what we own, the cars, the house, the cash. What matters is how we live and love and how we spend the dash. So think about this long and hard. There are things that you'd like to change, for you now know how much time is left that we can still have things rearranged. If we could just slow down enough to consider what's true and real, and always try to understand the way that other people feel. Be less quick to anger and show appreciation more, and love the people in our lives like you've never loved them before. If we treat each other with respect and more often wear a smile, remembering this special dash might only last a while. So when your eulogy is being read, with your life's action to rehash, would you be proud of the things they say and how you spent your dash?
I know that Tom is with us because the minute I came into church, I had to go to the bathroom. And that's not a joke. I don't have to say anything more about my love because my loves have said it all. What I do have to do is thank every one of you here who have supported us, and you have been the best, best friends. We don't have another priest like this. Remember that. He is also the best. And I'm not going to forget Deacon John because he was very good too yesterday. Thank you. Again, I thank you all. I thank you for your support. I know you will be there for me. And again, I can just say thank you.
I don't have my prepared speech. I said the other day, But let me just say this. Someone's getting it from the car. But let me say this from the heart. I've never seen a couple more loving. And I was really touched with the way Janet treated him for all these years. You really had to see it to believe it. It was absolutely wonderful. And as I said, and now I'm paraphrasing, but as I said, it was a real show of Christian love that we really should all aspire to. It was unbelievable. Thank you.
By the way, it's in the bulletin. The actual speech is in the bulletin, so you can all
your son Jesus left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey. Mercifully granted, strengthened by it, our brother Thomas William may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. My family, trusting God together, we pray together for your husband, your dad, your pop, your father-in-law, brother-in-law, your uncle, and your friend, Thomas. Now we come to the last farewell. There is sadness in parting, but take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see him again and enjoy his friendship. Although we will disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdom.
Therefore, let us console one another in the faith of Jesus Christ. This time, we take incense in party, incense sign of reverence, and our farewell. Our commence prayer to rise to the throne of God. As we do this, hold on your precious memories, your stories. Thank God for that. Pray for him, and pray for one another, especially Tom's family. I'm going to ask John to incense. We commend our beloved brother Thomas William in the sure and certain hope that together all who have died in Christ will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the many blessings which you bestowed upon Tom in his life. As a son, brother, husband, walk upon your face, the rain falls up upon your fields, until you meet again. May good and gracious God hold you in the palm of his hands. Almighty God, Father of all, you have strengthened us with the mystery of the cross, signed with the sacrament of your Son's resurrection. Mercifully grant that your servant Thomas, not freed from the toils of this life, may be joined with the company of all the chosen ones. Because God had chosen to call Thomas from this life to himself, we commit his body to be cremated. For we are dust, and to dust we shall return. But the Lord Jesus Christ will change our mortal bodies to be like his in glory. For he is risen, the firstborn from the dead. So let us commend our brother Tom to the Lord, that the Lord may embrace him in peace and raise up his body on the last day. Grant, O God, that while we lament the departure of this your servant Thomas, we may always remember that we are most certainly to follow him. Give us the grace to prepare for that last hour by a good life, that we may not be surprised by sudden and unprovided death, but be ever watchful, that when you call, we may enter into eternal glory. May Mary, the most merciful mother of God,
discomforter of those who mourn, commend to her son the soul of his servant, that through her motherly prayers, Thomas may pass through the gates of death and with her as a guide and joyful reach, his long for home in the heavenly banquet. We make this prayer to Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And finally, not to only give the big rounds of applause to Thomas, we have to give applause to Janet too, the way they lived life, a Christian life, good life, Catholic life, and give us an example for all of us how to be a married couple, how to a couple whose foundation is Jesus, whose foundation is love, and they live this life well. So put your hands together, give a big round of applause for John. Family, this banner of love and devotion now being folded is a living memorial of the courageous thoughts of our comrade Thomas William Reilly, the one you came here to honor this day. The blue field represents the sky that overlooks our land and denotes the watch The Red Stripes tells us the blood, sweat, and tears that has been offered and conquered by a Conrad Thomas. Devotion to the responsible freedom of his country. The White Stripes boldly proclaim the peace that Thomas helped to bring to future generations. This is Thomas's flag. This is our spiritual heritage. Receive it with the tears of our minds and the faith of our hearts. Amen.
As the United States, the Secretary of the Navy, and a grateful nation, please accept this flag and will be loved ones' faithful service, United States Navy. I'm sorry for your loss, sir.